So in this video, I'm going to show you how to construct a circumscribed circle. I started off by drawing a random triangle ABC, and it turns out this is an acute triangle because all the measures are less than 90 degrees for each angle. You can do this for a right triangle or an obtuse triangle as well. But when you circumscribe a circle, first you need to find the circumcenter. And the way you do that is you find the perpendicular bisector of each segment. And that's one of our first constructions that we learned. So I'm going to bisect segment AB first. Now the circumcenter lies at the intersection of the perpendicular bisectors. So there's one perpendicular bisector. And now I'll find the next segment, BC. There's our second perpendicular bisector. Now really all you need is two intersections because all three perpendicular bisectors intersect at the same point, and two intersections will tell you where the point is. But I like to do all three just to make sure I didn't make a mistake. So this third one just kind of verifies the findings. Okay, so there's the point of intersection right here of the three perpendicular bisectors. I'll call that point P. So point P is what's called the circumcenter of the circle. So the circumcenter is found by finding the intersection of the three perpendicular bisectors. Now to circumscribe the circle, what you need to do is put the pointy end of the compass on the circumcenter and then adjust the width until the pencil reaches exactly to one of the vertices. Now, the thing is about the circumcenter, it is equidistant from all three vertices of the triangle. So what you can do is you can draw a circle, and that circle should intersect all three vertices of the triangle, if you did this right. Now, my pencil's a little bit off here. Okay, now it's in the right spot. Let's try this again. Okay, so there you go. Now notice all three vertices are on the triangle. And the center is at point P, the circumcenter. So this triangle has now been circumscribed in circle. And the distance from the circumcenter to each vertex is the same. Now the radius of the circle represents the distance to each vertex. So if I were to draw segment PA, PB, and PC, those would all have the same measure because they're the radius of this circle right here. So that's how you construct a circumscribed circle.